gangster with the legs of the gangster. There should be a gang, but nobody's been brave enough to do that yet. Okay. So this dude, David O'Reilly, back in like 5 or 6 years ago, did an animation where Walt Disney's head spun through the air on a plate. And he had modeled it himself, so it's like his own design. So it's not like he didn't dig Walt Disney up, scan him. This is not a scan, this is his thing. So there's Walt Disney. Here's a brain. Here's brain Walt. Make the gangster to go pee. More sad than up now. Okay, so this is where everything stood about, I'd say, 6 months ago. And I was like, you know what? I think the gangster, he can't top, bringing Walt Disney's peeing. Like, functionally peeing, like, he can really pee. I think we've come. This is probably the, like, sort of, like, you know how trees grow and they sometimes grow to their maximum height? Well, like, let's just put fertilizer on that. This is and this is cool. I want to show up in the park. Then she asked me, like, are these pieces? No. My hands. So then I was on Colbert, and so we scanned him. And so, of course, but interestingly enough, Colbert spun out a whole other meme of Colbert mashups. You know, we've got Colbert Thulu with the octopus. You've got the cold bear. He's deadly afraid of bears. And this is all going to get easier and better. The future is bright for mashups and silliness in the digital design space. We just did this. We made it. It used to be when you uploaded something, when you wanted to do a derivative, you could only say, like, okay, that tractor that you uploaded, I made a tractor, but I added a person onto it, so I did a derivative of yours. But I can only do a derivative of one thing. You can only have one parent. And we know that the whole thing that happened with mashups is it says you need to have more than one parent for your digital design so that you can mash them together. They can have babies. Stop there. We're going to have version control so you can do not just, so you're training Walt Disney stuff. You can do different versions of it, and then people can say, I didn't like version 4, I like the print version 2. And there's more things that are showing up to match up. It goes on. It just doesn't stop. Like, of course, there's the gangsta with Tony Buser's head and a robot head, and you can actually take any bobblehead and put it on its stock. There's not necessarily a good reason for it, but it's one of those things where some people can do it. They will. And you will, because you're people. Isaac Deeds uploaded his hand, and then of course they had to go on the gangsta. Oh, and recently this hand got changed and modified so you could put LEDs in. Everything's better without these. So, we kind of come around full circle. This is WiseOrc, who created the gangsta. And somebody uploaded Yoda's head. And so we've got Yosa or Gangda. And we're kind of a nice, this just happened the other day. So we're at a nice, like, stopping place. So, you all need to leave here and create your own mashup. You need to cruise Thingiverse. There's 10,000 things. You don't have to have any skill whatsoever to do this. In fact, skill might hamper you in this game. And Probably the easiest thing to use is a tool called Mesh Mixer. And Mesh Mixer, I mean, I don't know why you'd want to mix a naked guy with a horse and an elephant in your head, but you can. This is a really nice program that lets you take something, cut the head off something else and put it on it, and you should all just quickly note Mesh Mixer for your mashup and so on later on. If you are, how many of you are programmers? Or have had programmed before? Okay, awesome. You're gonna like OpenSCAD. OpenSCAD is a parametric modeling language. It literally lets you say, okay, I have a circle, a sphere, and I'm gonna put it at 0, 0, 0, coordinate space. And it's gonna have a radius of 3. And that's all you need to define a sphere. And then you can say, I'm gonna also have a cylinder, and I'm also gonna put it at 0, 0, 0 in space, and it's gonna be 3 long and 0.5 in diameter or something like that. So you've got in the center, you put two things in the same space. Well, then you do what's called a Boolean operation, which is another way of just saying subtraction. And you make this the cylinder go away, and what you're left with is a bead. So there's a circle with a hole through it. And we've just programmed an object. OpenSCAD lets you program physical objects, and it's very, very powerful. You can do many, many stupid things with it. There's also all sorts of other wonderful things. 123D is going to be talking next, and they do really straightforward 3D modeling, and there's a bunch of different ways you can do it. That's an Autodesk product. You can spend as much money as you want on this. You can get AutoCAD or SolidWorks and spend thousands of dollars on a license every year. You can also, I'm cheap, so I'm like, okay, OpenSCAD, all three things, Blender is great. Even Google SketchUp is a really powerful program that you can use. And I've seen 3-year-olds use Google SketchUp. There's some new stuff that's come out with that you can do in the browser. Tinkercad and 3DTIN are both really powerful products. So there should be nothing that stops you from designing and sharing. If you have an idea that you want to exist in 3D, you can design it, you can share it on Thingiverse. If you have a Megabyte, you can print it out. If you don't, just upload it to Thingiverse. Other people will. And then they'll take pictures of it. And it'll be like, they're awesome. Mm-hmm. So what makes this happen is a culture of sharing. We're kind of obsessed with this. And this culture of sharing, we are actually in the dawn of the age of sharing. We're still at the beginning of the age of sharing. So if you get into this and you start sharing your stuff, you're like a revolutionary. You get to know the band before they get signed, kind of thing. So share your stuff. You can do it on the Thingiverse if it's digital designs. If it's something you've made, do it on Instructables. Actually, even though I'd love for you to upload a Thingiverse, I don't care where you upload it. I just want you to upload it and share your work that you've done because it makes the world better. And think of the children. They need to know. They don't get to know what's in your brain unless you actually document it. So, again, open source or die. Literally, if you die and you don't publish your stuff, your life has been wasted. And I say that with tongue-in-cheek, but it's true. Another thing that happens is, when you share things, sometimes they take on a life of their own. A user named Sid Wilch, Matthew Gallant, is a guy who lives in New Jersey. And he's not New Jersey. Oh, that'd be cool. He decided he was just going to make an escapement. And an escapement is the part of a grandfather clock that goes back and forth and keeps time. It uses gravity and to pull on a weight, and things move back and forth, and it, because of the power of the Earth and gravity, it keeps time. Really cool technology from the 1700s. And he thought, wouldn't it be cool if I just made an escape? Just I want to try that part. He did. And then, of course, he made it. And it kind of worked. And everybody was like, you're making a 3D printed clock, aren't you? And he was like, in his head, he's like,